We see this night as a night of celebration, a celebration of our great Bahamian athletes, a celebration of our Bahamian sports heroes, our managers, our coaches, our sponsors, administrators, and meritorious members. We have come to celebrate their accomplishment. We have come to celebrate the standard that they have set, that those that will come behind them must run faster, must jump higher, must leap further, and must play harder in order to surpass what they have done.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've come tonight to serve recognition to those hard-mouthed now and think she's a woman, but she was once a 13-year-old who couldn't get to the ballpark because her mother wouldn't let her go, Candice Comer. And then there are little red boys like Basil Sands and Zach, just trying to run track and shoot hoops. And Hall of Famers had already come and gone, like Nico Grant, big head, snotty-nosed boy from West End, a Hall of Famer. And then there's Softly Robbins, who couldn't find a girlfriend until he learned how to play basketball. And it went on. John Martin caused much confusion. We didn't know if he should come as a sponsor, a baseball player, or a track athlete. But we knew one thing, he was too shy to ever do an interview on radio. And then there's Hunters, a boy called Fletcher Lewis, the only Grand Bahama born, the first Grand Bahama born to make the finals of the Olympics. And people seem to have forgotten. There is a deceased one called Zulu Williams, 69, the second to be Mr. Grand Bahama in bodybuilding. And in 72, he took along his student Dwight Palacios to be in Mr. Universe. These were exciting times. And there are some we have forgotten, but they must come another time. Gary Davis, a boxer. Fine, he represented the Bahamas at the Olympics in Munich. All these and more, we've come tonight to celebrate. The wait has been long, but never long enough. Never short enough, and never good enough. Jim White had money long before George Steinbrenner. He never produced his Yankees, but he had a stadium named after him, and that's where little boys like John Martin could play, the Jim White Sports Arena. And Preston Stewart, he was poor then, but he could write sports. He gave recognition to these boys a long time ago. This is why we've come, so that all the lies can stop in the bar rooms, the boardrooms, and every place else about who hit a home run and who was the fastest runner. We have tracked down the records, and only those whose names are called tonight will truly be noted as Hall of Famers. And then there's Anita Doherty, hard-mouthed red girl from West End who traveled the world because of her ability to do things in sneakers. And then my stepfather, the biggest, most loving man I know, Errol Bodie, who took me on an airplane and gave me a scholarship. These thankless souls who have never been recognized truly, tonight we've come to say you're in Hall of Famer. And then there's Wayne Smith, who must wait yet another 4 years, I believe. But he's produced so many Hall of Famers himself. And that is the kind of people we've brought here on Grand Bahama. Charifta, Olympics, you name it. Grand Bahamians, Grand Bahama residents, we've done it all. And before we make these long speeches at funerals, it is nights like tonight when we're all alive and we can laugh and talk about it, but we should congratulate ourselves. His nephew Pop used to come bragging at Hawksbill about his uncle Rio, who knew everything and anything about baseball. And then there was Dashi, who wanted to own a team so badly he called them Boss Bird. But these are men who were dedicated, committed to sports, like all of you and all of us, we've come tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, I ask that you give them a hand as they stand and take the outside of the room. All of our sports inductees, please go to the outside. Loxley Thompson, Clint Moultrie, Emil Hidokity, Errol Bodie, Jim White, Frank Cox Rowe, Rio Williams, Preston Stewart, John Martin, Bernard Aronoff, Oscar Thompson, Austin Bernie Davis, Lawrence McIntosh, Neville Hammer Cartwright, Lula Mae Walker Fackerson, Candice de Gregory Culmer, Adelaide Navarrety Pinder, Nell Russell, Basil the Kid Sands, Keith Mullings, Dashwell Dashy Williams, Charlie Softly Robbins, Ronnie McKenzie, Gart Woodside, and Bernie Butler. First inductees into the Grand Bahama Sports Hall of Fame. Bahama Sports Hall of Fame. They will long be remembered. Boys like John Martin and Keith Mullings, Emil Poitier for his bodybuilding, Charlie Softly Robbins, Preston Stewart, Rio Williams, Basil the Kid Sands, and the great contributions of Jim White. It is the sacrifices made by Errol Bodie, the late nights at the ballpark by Frank Cox Rowe. These are the men and women who made it happen. It's a teenager going abroad to represent the Bahamas with a myth and a bat called Candice Culmer. It's Dashy Williams making basketball what it is now on Grand Bahama. Bernie Davies, his dedication to the sport of softball, making Foco feel a historic mark. When the history books are written, these are the men and women that will be remembered. Our first inductees into the Grand Bahama Sports Hall of Fame. History would record that a barefoot boy from Hunters makes it to the finals in long jump in 76 at the Olympic Games, Fletcher Lewis. And an 8 mile rock girl, talented and swift, called Nell Russell, will help bring the Bahamas to rank third in the world in softball. These are the men and women who made sports what it is on Grand Bahama, and by extension, the Bahamas. The Grand Bahama Sports Hall of Fame, our first and historic inductees. The records will show that on that night they were flanked by an International Softball Hall of Famer himself from West End, Nico Grant, and a boy called Christie, Greg Christie, an inductee, a Hall of Famer himself, and that talented Eleuthera man, son of the soil, with a national stadium bearing his name, Churchill Tenenbaums. These are the men and women that have made history tonight. The Grand Bahama Sports Hall of Fame. Let's give our inductees yet another big hand. Hall of Famers.
Sports is a universal language. It knows no boundaries, has no prejudices, it does not discriminate, and everyone participates. It brings peoples together. Some of the poorest nations rally around their athletes. When the economies are poor and the people in despair, they turn to sports. In our country, we have been privileged. We've been privileged to have outstanding athletes. But having the athletes alone didn't make sports work in Grand Bahama. I look at the athletes and the others chosen this evening for induction into the Hall of Fame. And I recognize that the organizers did a very smart thing. They began by appreciating Bahamians who put their hands into their pockets to create the opportunities, to create the platforms to allow many of our athletes the opportunity to participate locally, to allow them an education, and then to allow them to participate on the national level. And so I think it is significant that you have recognized people like Jim White, people like Preston Stewart, people like Dashi Williams. And I remember when Basil Sands was attending school, and I remember when Boss Bird was a teen, and I remember when Dashi made sure he got his ticket to come home and play. And I remember when he would come home and play. I've seen moves on the basketball court, Basil Sands being the author of those moves. I have not seen some, even in the NBA to this day. He certainly is perhaps I dare say, and I will argue, that he is perhaps still the best guard that this country has ever had.